tragic. I mean, that's worst case scenario. You never want a kid to have anything happen.
Breaking news at 5, a 16-year-old girl died in a horrific crash, and 5 other children aged 8 to 18 were seriously injured when a car T-boned this SUV.
The cars collided last night in Alva, where State Road 80 meets Joe Boulevard. Troopers say a 39-year-old woman failed to yield and caused that crash. NBC2's Joe Petrello got a closer look at where this happened, and he joins us now in our studio.
Florida Highway Patrol troopers say the crash happened because a woman failed to yield at the intersection. And people we spoke with who pass this area every day say it's a dangerous place to drive.
There's accidents all up and down this freeway, all the time.
13 years ago, this deadly crash at State Road 80 and Joel Boulevard sparked change.
I do not want one more child to be hurt.
Leslie Ward created the Alva Road Watch Committee. She collected thousands of signatures for a petition to add traffic lights at both 80 and Joel. It was a success, and the lights are here. But a woman who works by this intersection says it hasn't stopped others from driving dangerously.
Coming in here, I drive 25 miles to get in, and nobody does 45. Nobody does it. At least 60, sometimes 70 miles an hour.
And last night, this happened. Alva firefighters took this photo of a flipped-over SUV after troopers say 39-year-old Palm Beach County woman Christina Darling failed to yield. We know 6 people aged 18 and under went to the hospital with serious injuries. And a 16-year-old in Darling's car, Sija Stone, died just before midnight.
Tragic. I mean, that's worst case scenario. You never want a kid to have anything happen.
Alva firefighter Ethan Janey says drivers have to be more aware, especially at a high-speed intersection like this.
Pay attention to the turn signals of other people, watch your blind spots.
Though these lights have helped, Janey stresses the only thing that can put an end to these crashes is careful driving.
Troopers say Christina Darling now faces a charge for failing to yield. She hasn't been arrested yet, but their investigation is not over so far. I'm live in the studio, Joe Petrello.